Matching clothing, infusing colors is not rocket science. There is no one size fits all, and that is because every person, whether you are a man or you're a woman, you have different styles. Hi people, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Faith. I'm a personal shopper and men's fashion enthusiast. I help men source and shop fashion items and deliver to their doorsteps hassle-free. I also provide care tips and guides to maintain fashion items. On this channel, I talk about men's fashion, tips and hacks, fashion guides, and I also talk about personal shopping. This is my 20th video on this channel, and I'm so excited. I want to appreciate you all for watching my videos, for sticking with me these past few weeks. And if you are new here, click the subscribe button right now and also turn on the notification bell just beside it so that you can get updates every single time I drop a video. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about how to match clothing for men. I see that so many men find it confusing to match their clothing. You're not sure whether a particular item will work with another, you're not sure which patterns to pair together, you're not even sure how to pair your shirt and your tie. And so you see many men playing it safe. Everyone is just doing their grays, they are doing black, they are doing brown. Okay, so today I'm going to be sharing a few tips that can help you to match colors, to match your clothing, and to infuse colors along the line. So the first thing to note is that matching clothing, infusing colors is not rocket science. There is no one size fits all, and that is because every person, whether you are a man or you're a woman, you have different style personalities. Some men can infuse as many colors as possible without caring because that's their style personality. They are fearless, they want to take a risk, they don't really mind. Whereas some men, their style personality is to really keep it simple and they're not trying to just play it safe. That's just their style personality. So And there are some men that are open to options, they are open to infusing colors, but they are not really sure how to go about it, so they just play it safe. If you are in any of these categories, trust me, the tips I'm going to be sharing right now is going to really help you. So the first thing is, when you want to start matching your clothing, I'm going to advise you to start in bits. Yes, just like anything else that you are trying out for the first time, start little by little. So many men have their wardrobe essentials, their wardrobe starting with a neutral base, which is really good. So you can begin to infuse color and match your clothing by infusing one pop of color at a time. So let's take your neutral base, for example, your gray. If you look at this picture, you'll see that he's wearing a gray suit, a white shirt, and then he has infused color with his tie and shoe. That is how to do it. So you infuse color little by little. Start in small bits. The second thing you can do is to pick one color, then you adjust the intensity. So you can try to wear one particular color. By the time we are looking at you from head to toe, you're actually wearing maybe just blue, but you are increasing and decreasing the intensity depending on what you're wearing. So maybe your trouser is a darker shade of blue, your shirt is a lighter shade of blue. Okay, and then you now use a darker shade of tie or blue for your tie. Okay, so that is another tip that you can implement. The third tip is to contrast. Contrast is so key. It makes you see the everyday man. You see that person in your office that is looking sharp all the time. That is basically what he is doing. He is contrasting, and this is what I mean by contrast. So you are doing maybe your lighter shade at the top, darker shade at the bottom, and light colors of shoes. Okay, so you are doing light up, dark bottom, light shoes, or you are doing dark top, light bottom, dark shoes. But I need to warn you, I have mentioned before that your physique type is so important, and that is because it's going to help you to know whether to put a lighter shade at the top or a darker shade at the top. If you are broad, or you are on the plus size and you are trying to give an illusion of a slim body, I'm not going to advise you to put anything light at the top. So you want to look at dark colors for the top. If you are slim and you want to add a bit of volume to your body, then you can put on light top and then dark bottoms. Okay, so now another tip I'm going to give you is to complement, don't match. And what I mean by that is the aim is not for you to necessarily match everything you're putting on, like your shirt is white, your pants is white, your shoe is white, you know, that's not the aim. The aim is actually to complement your colors. And this is what I mean. There are primary colors. We have your red and green, your yellow and purple, your blue and orange. And you're already thinking, oh, am I going to wear all of these colors together? The trick is to make one of them darker. So if you're wearing red shirt, for example, and you want to wear green, you can use a dark shade of green. And you're going to be looking like you have put in so much effort, alright? So you can do your red check shirt, for example, and your olive green chinos. See? That's simple. The other thing I'm going to say, I said it before when I was talking about wardrobe essentials, you need to look at investing in neutrals. Men's neutrals is not limited to black, to white, and you can also include colors like your khaki, your gray, your light blue, your navy, your tan. All of these are men's neutrals. Okay, you can, the reason why these colors are so important is you can pair them together. They almost go, in fact, they will go effortlessly, and then you can implement other colors with them. Okay, so now let's go to the tips on matching your shirt and your tie. I want to really touch on all of these things because it is so broad. This topic is so broad, but I want to give you like simple tips so that you can always build upon it later on. Okay, so now let's talk about patterns. I'm going to be using shirts for example. Okay, so when you're trying to pair patterns together, you need to mix them in different scales. What I mean by that is that you're not pairing a tie of the same size of polka dots, for example, let's say that's the pattern on it, with a shirt of the same size of polka dots. Okay, so you're contrasting. So you can either use smaller patterns on your tie and then big patterns on your shirt, or vice versa. Okay, so you can have striped, big stripes on your shirt and then tiny stripes on your tie. I hope you get that. Also, you can try to infuse other patterns. You can infuse your polka dots, like I mentioned before, your flowery patterns, but don't ever forget that trick of making one pattern smaller than the other. All right, so another thing is you can pair your pattern shirt with your pattern tie as long as they are not in the same size. I already mentioned. What I'm going to say next is that don't pair a shirt and tie of the same pattern. If your shirt, for example, is vertical striped, let your tie be horizontal striped. Okay,
when you're pairing patterns and solids,
don't pair your solid shirts with ties of predominantly the same color. And this is what I mean. Even if that shirt, even if that tie is patterned, you don't want to pair your light blue shirt, for example, with a light blue tie. It will make your shirt and your tie bleed. That means that we are only seeing one thing. We are really not seeing the difference. Okay, now let's go to matching stuff that matters. And that is talking about your leather and your metals. I have mentioned it before that you pair your leather with the same color, your belt and your shoe. But it can be overwhelming trying to find the same shade. What I'm going to advise you to do is to make sure that the colors are similar. Okay, they are not too far from each other. The same thing with your metals. Try to pair similar shades of metals together. Okay, all of these are guidelines, not rules. You can always experiment, you can always infuse, you can always do your own type of thing, but make sure that there is something complementing another thing on your outfit. All right, I hope you have found these tips helpful. Let me know which of them in particular you have found really helpful and you will be implementing. Thank you so much for watching my video today. I'm going to see you next week. In the meantime, if you have not subscribed, make sure you click the subscribe button right now. Thank you so much, and I'll see you next time. Bye.